road construction, groundbreakings, new home construction, all signs of growth. It's something that Baldwin County residents have become accustomed to in recent years. Now, more than ever, there's a push to keep up with a population that's growing faster than any other in the state. New home construction is on the rise and doesn't look to be slowing down anytime soon.
We were the first house that was built in here by Trulin in almost 5 years. So as soon as our house got broke down, started getting done, then the next house, then the next house, then the next house.
Terry Dillard's home is just one of many Trulin homes is building in Austin Park Estates and other subdivisions around the county. While not at its height of 2007, the new home market is booming again to keep up with the growth.
We've been growing for the last 4 or 5 years at about a 20 to 30% rate. And already this year, we're well on our way to record numbers in sales.
It's easy to see why when you see the numbers. Census reports estimate Baldwin County's growth between 2010 and 2017 at 16.7%, surpassing 30,000 people. From 2016 to 17 alone, the county added more than 5,000 residents. With the growth come some concerns.
Our county roads can't handle what they're doing now. So a lot of our neighbors, we've talked about it, that's what we're worried about, is the roads, the schools.
The school system's pay-as-you-go program consists of a long-term strategic plan to address growing student populations and build new schools. Restore funding from the BP settlement is allowing for the widening of several state highways. As for county roads in and out of growing suburbs, county officials say it will likely take the state letting more Baldwin County money stay at home to make that happen.
At the end of the day, the state of Alabama and those folks in Montgomery have got to realize that it is time for Baldwin County to get its share of state spending and state revenue, and that's simply not happening right now.
And that's been a big point of contention for some time. The way that works is Baldwin County, as every county, sends a percentage of their sales tax, their lodging tax, and so on to Montgomery. That tax money then gets divvied up back throughout every county in the state. And since Baldwin County provides such a big percentage of that, county leaders want to see more of that money stay here at home. Now, on a side note, I did want to mention that just in a 10-month period in 2017, Baldwin County added 4,000 new jobs, so another good sign there. Reporting live from Baldwin County, Hal Sherrick, Fox 10 News.
And across the bay, the census estimates for Mobile County show the population declining, but not by much. The Census Bureau estimate compares July 1st of 2017 to the year before, and as you can see, Mobile County lost about 900 people. Mayor Sandy Stimson says quality of life is an important part of keeping people in Mobile.
The thing that's most visible has to do with the infrastructure. Everybody sees that we're fixing that. But other things that need to be fixed has to do with public housing. Education needs to be fixed. And so as those things are fixed, you know, people will quit leaving to go somewhere else because those things will improve the quality of life.
The census estimates came out today for areas all over the country.